Are you considering making a move to Johnson City, Tennessee? Well, in this video, I'm going to talk about what you can expect if you plan to relocate here. So stay tuned. Everyone, I'm Tiffany Watts, a local realtor here in the Johnson City area. If you're thinking about relocating here, then reach out. Here's my contact info. I love it when people reach out to me when they're thinking about relocating here. I've had several people over the past few weeks from California, New Jersey, New York, reaching out wanting more information about this area. But anyway, let's dive in. Johnson City is located in Northeast Tennessee and is sometimes referred to as the Tri-Cities, which makes up Johnson City, Kingsport, and Bristol. As of this year, 2021, Johnson City's population is 71,000 people. Washington County, which is where Johnson City is located, its population has grown by 8.1% over the past 10 years. The state of Tennessee as a whole has grown by 8.9% over the past 10 years, with only 2.2% of that being the Northeast Tennessee region. Johnson City has a small town atmosphere to it, and we aren't super close or really super far from major cities. Charlotte, North Carolina is about 3 hours away, so it's about 148 miles. Nashville, Tennessee is about 284 miles away, which is about a 4 hour drive. And Atlanta, Georgia is 256 miles away, which is also about a 4 hour drive. We do have a small airport here locally, and it's located in Blountville, and it's not an international airport. But it's nice because I've never had to wait in any lines there. All right, moving on. So the unemployment rate for the state of Tennessee is 4.9%. And right now it's August of 2021. And currently the US average is 5.4%. So Tennessee is lower than not only the US average, but they're also lower than states like California and New York. Now we also have some great local colleges. ETSU is right here in Johnson City, and we have several more throughout the Tri-Cities. All right, so moving on. We don't have any pro sports really around here, so some people might see that as a downside, but we do have an Appalachian League for baseball, and that's pretty cool. But what we do have here locally is the Bristol Motor Speedway. So if you're a NASCAR fan, we've got you covered. We have loads of outdoor activities: boating, camping, fishing, hunting, rafting, biking, hiking, swimming, skiing, zip lining, and horseback riding. But if you're not really an outdoorsy person, we also have things that you might like. Maybe you like to shop. We have plenty of places where you can go shopping. We've got some cute small businesses that you're not gonna find anywhere else. And we've got the normal stores too, like Hobby Lobby, Bath & Body Works, Carter's, Victoria's Secret, and we just got a Home Goods just this past week. It opened up, and I know a lot of the locals were excited about that. And if you're curious, it is located at the mall at Johnson City, where the old Sears used to be. Now, we've also got some great restaurants around here. We've got your hole-in-the-wall mom-and-pop places that you're not going to see anywhere else. And then we've also got the chain, normal, dine-in, fast food places, Olive Garden, Texas Roadhouse. And I know I've mentioned this in other videos, but we also have some really great options for fresh food. So we've got like farmers markets and Amish markets where you can find some really great fresh stuff. And I definitely can't go without mentioning our food trucks. We have some kick butt food trucks around here, and I was finally able to try the lobster dog truck, and oh my gosh, it was amazing. After living on the coast in Florida for 5 years, never have I ever, after having all of that fresh seafood there, have I ever had anything as good as the lobster dog. All right, moving on to the people. So I do get this question a lot. What are the people like here? Well, basically, most of them are friendly and very hospitable. If you're coming from a state where the people aren't very friendly, then it might take a little bit for you to warm up to the people here, and it might maybe scare you a little bit how nice everybody is. Just walking by strangers and people saying hi to you, or driving through a neighborhood and the neighbors just waving at you as you drive by. And speaking of driving, traffic isn't all that bad here, and you might actually think it's great if you're coming from a state who has traffic nightmares. Now, we have our fair share of bad drivers here, just like any town does, but it is a little bit more tolerable because of the lack of traffic. Now, if you're curious about the weather that we have here in Johnson City, we have four seasons. We have nice mild weather here in the spring and the fall. It gets cold in the winter and sometimes snow. And in the summer, we have hot days too. Some days will reach over 90 degrees. So if you're thinking about relocating from somewhere that has nice mild weather all year round, you may want to consider how our weather might not be for you. So what I've been getting a lot lately from my clients that are relocating here from out of state is that they desperately want privacy. Some people want several acres of land, and others just want to know that they're not constantly being watched by their neighbors. And I'm wondering what in the world's going on in some of these neighborhoods that you guys are moving from. And that is something we have a lot of here, is land. And we do have a shortage of available listings for people to purchase here, just like so many other places are having the same issue. But what a lot of people are opting to do is to purchase the land first, and then they're building a brand new house on it. And speaking of homes for sale, if you're curious on how much it would cost you to purchase a house here, the average sales price for the month of July 2021 was around $240,000. And that's up 15% from this time last year. And this is stats that I obtained from the Northeast Tennessee Regional MLS. So if you're wanting a decent three-bedroom home, you're probably going to spend anywhere from $200,000 to $300,000. And that's depending on the location and different things inside the home. And if you're looking for a four-bedroom, then chances are it's going to be a little bit more than that. Now, there are homes available under the $200,000 price point range, but whenever you find those homes, usually it comes with some sort of a sacrifice to the buyer's search criteria, whether it's the square footage, the exact location or neighborhood that they want to be in, or cosmetic updates. So although our home sales prices have been going up here in the area, just like so many other places, we are still way lower than the U.S. average. And I believe that's one of the two main reasons people want to relocate here. Number one, because our cost of living is pretty awesome. And two, because of our mountains. We have breathtaking views of the Blue Ridge and Smoky Mountains. Who doesn't like to vacation to the mountains every now and then? Or better yet, move where you vacation. But like I said in the beginning of the video, if you're considering relocating to Northeast Tennessee, let me know. I want to work with you. Please consider subscribing if you would like to see more videos about the Johnson City area, and thanks for watching.